This bulletin proudly brought to you in association with Alex Campbell's Menswear.
Tonight on The South Today, Dunedin's Anglican Church denies that it may have to sell the century-old St. Paul's Church in the Octagon, but there is more to this story. For many, the weekend is not one of chilling and a little light gardening. These competitors will be giving their all. And Riverton's South Coast Environment Centre reaches a goal they've been eyeing for almost two decades. A very good Friday evening, I'm Craig Story. The head of Dunedin's St. Paul's Anglican Church, the Bishop of Dunedin, Calvin Wright, has today denied suggestions the church is broke and troubled. And Bishop Wright moved to scotch any suggestions that the church's 98-year-old cathedral in the Octagon might be put up for sale. Roselle LeBone has more on this story.
The St. Paul's Cathedral congregation might be dwindling, and the Anglican Church might be reducing the number of its Dunedin parishes, but that does not mean its cathedral in the Octagon is likely to be put up for sale.
The issues are the same as every parish church, except the stakes are bigger here.
Questions over the future of the cathedral were raised by Anglican Dean, the Very Reverend Dr. Trevor James, in the Otago Daily Times this morning. He revealed the church was considering reducing the number of its Dunedin parishes from 7 to 5, and said the diocese was broke and the church troubled. But today, he too discounted any possibility of the cathedral leaving church hands.
I think that there's a great resolve in the church to keep the cathedral going. Obviously, if there were no people in the church, then that would have to be looked at. We'd have to think about what else do we do with this building.
While he believed the cathedral's future needed to be considered alongside other parishes at risk, Bishop Wright considered the cathedral a special case.
It's a very strategic location and it's a beautiful building, but very expensive to maintain. And there is no question, nobody has ever suggested that we should sell it or get rid of it. The question is how we best use it.
He said he was flabbergasted by reports of infighting in the church.
I don't think it's a fight. I think that we are having a discussion about the use of our resources.
The ODT discussed infighting in a way that's going on in the diocese. Is there validity to that?
I think there's always going to be disagreements of personalities, and there will always be certain dimensions of rivalry.
Bishop Wright said while the cathedral's immediate future was secure, there was a need for it to be used for more commercial purposes.
The diocese is an organisation which actually is very well resourced, but it's asset rich and cash poor.
Reverend Trevor James said today no serious offer had been made by any buyer to purchase the cathedral. The issue will be discussed further by three representatives from the cathedral and the diocese. Roselle LeBone, The South Today.
A man has died early this morning after being involved in a workplace accident at Southport in Bluff. Emergency services were called to the scene at around 1:45 this morning after receiving reports a worker had been seriously injured after being run over by a loader. The 54-year-old man died at the scene a short time later. Police are now in the process of notifying next of kin. Victim support services have been offered to the other staff at the scene. WorkSafe New Zealand are investigating and the death has been referred to the coroner. Well, no doubt there'll be plenty of blood, sweat and tears over the next weekend for 300 athletes in the God's Own Adventure Race. The race starts at 7 o'clock in the morning on Saturday in the main beach in Queenstown Bay. But for today, the competitors were making their last-minute preparations. Mina Amso was amongst the athletes.
The teams have less than 24 hours to figure out how they will navigate 410 kilometres New Zealand wilderness in a non-stop race that can take some a week to complete.
Hello Mina, I'm so at the top of Skyline Gondola where the teams have been briefed about safety, navigation, what to do, what not to do, and of course are now completing their registrations and are going to be ready for tomorrow's race.
Renowned Queenstown adventure racer Chris Fawn is looking forward to his sixth Godzone race.
Expect it's going to be anything too technical, but sometimes, you know, in the slightly easier terrain, there's more options for teams going different directions or smaller route choice. So I'm kind of hopeful that, you know, there'll be a bit of that out there.
Fawn will be navigating, trekking, canoeing, mountain biking and more with his team, Yearland's Family Wines.
Yeah, but no, it should be a fun race. And yeah, we're sort of, I guess as a team, quite excited to make sure we enjoy ourselves and have a, you know, we're obviously out there to try and win, but we definitely want to enjoy the experience.
Race director Warren Bates is looking forward to the start of the race tomorrow morning.
I think it's a huge sigh of relief to see the teams after a year of preparation getting off and starting on this amazing adventure.
Bates spent the last 12 months setting out the race course that explores the Waikatipo Basin.
It is built around three or four core disciplines: kayaking, canoeing, running and biking. And then we layer in different disciplines which fit Queenstown or whatever district we're in. So that this year has got rafting, gorgeering, and, you know, this is the adventure capital of the world. We're doing a few things that really reflect, you know, what makes Queenstown, Queenstown.
Godzone has 10 stages and is regarded as one of the most technically challenging expeditions in the world. One prologue involving 8 disciplines. Rina Amso, The South Today.
Here's another story from Queenstown. A woman had her driving license immediately suspended in the early hours of the morning. Police say she was caught allegedly drink driving and was found to be more than 4 times over the legal limit. Senior Sergeant Paula Inoka says the 25-year-old local woman was randomly stopped by officers while driving on Earl Street. Check this out. She blew a breath alcohol reading of 1,189 micrograms. To put that into perspective, for drivers 20 years and over, the limit is 250 micrograms or 50 milligrams of blood. The woman's license was, of course, instantly suspended, but police could not say when she would appear in court. A community hub in Riverton has met its fundraising target to buy the building they operate from. The South Coast Environment Centre has been working from the same estuary front location for 15 years and it's looking forward to staying there indefinitely.
From protecting Jacob's estuary to providing education on organic living, the South Coast Environment Centre has been a hub for environmentalists for 20 years. 15 of those have been in the same building, which will now become its permanent location. Hi, I'm Ruby Spink in Riverton, outside the South Coast Environment Centre, which has met their fundraising target to buy the building.
We are very thrilled at how generous people have been, and so we've had over 300 pledges and donations from all over the world and all over New Zealand. And so we're up to $60,000 now. So it's pretty exciting. We've got $13,000 to go.
The donations coming from over 20 countries will provide the bond for purchasing the building, with the final $13,000 needing to be paid by the end of March. Guyton's planning activities to collect the last part of the payment.
So we're going to have two or three little events, like a film evening, and we're going to have a clothing swap day, and we've got 100 little boxes, I'm going to sell them for $5 each and put a mystery envelope and have a mystery box. That would be quite fun. We have a harvest festival at the end of the month, so we'll do some special things there to fundraise at that.
The centre gets 50 to 100 visitors per day. Many of them are tourists from around the world. Guyton says there's been lots of supportive comments online left by people who'd visited on their way down the Southern Scenic Route.
I love to get so many nice comments from people around New Zealand, around the world, saying they were there, you know, 10 years ago and they wanted to make sure we're there for the future, so it's lovely.
Once the payment's gone through, the team of volunteers at the Environment Centre will get back to work on the upgrades they're planning for the building, including a mezzanine reading level overlooking the estuary and sheds out back for the seed saving group. I'm Ruby Spink for The South Today.
Stay you are where you are, because still to come on The South Today, when you've been the nucleus of some of O-Week's best ever events and it's time to put your feet up, just where do you do it? We ask coordinator extraordinaire Dan Hendra the tough questions. Yes, I'm a bit shaggy. Maybe I need a haircut. Maybe I should ask Stacey Warrington. She'd know.
Hello. Granddad loved his family and surfing, in that order. He taught me to surf, and we spent a lot of time in the water together over the years. When he died, I strapped the camera to the nose of his old board and filmed the paddle out at St. Clair. Gillian's played the video on the big screen at his funeral. Granddad would have loved having everyone come out one last surf for them.
Gillian's Funeral Services, helping families celebrate the lives of their loved ones for generations. Gillians.co.nz. Here is this week's Mole Map UV report. Did you know if you tan easily or have dark skin, you're still at risk of skin cancer?
If you've ever been on a sunbed or been badly sunburnt, what are the chances you could have melanoma? Remove the doubt. Get a mole map.
Active Furnishes Limited, home of quality service with superior product and an in-house design team who are always happy to advise and create an imaginative solution for you. Active Furnishes Limited, part of Dunedin's design history.
If you've always dreamed of building a new home or renovating your existing home, make it happen. Go to the home show, 3rd, 4th, 5th of March at the More FM Arena at the Edgar Centre. Adults $10, children free. See you at the home show.
The University of Otago, New Zealand's only true collegiate university. For first-year students, the history, the expectations of excellence are...
unfamiliar.
G'day, I'm next door.
Hi, next door. I'm Samantha Pascoe.
No, you're not. I'm Josh, Clyde, science. And you are?
Sam, Hastings, law and arts.
Tane, Auckland, commerce.
Osaka, Greece, classics. Ah, history.
Silverhorn Active Manuka Honey from the natural Manuka forests of New Zealand. Buy one 250 gram pot for $34.90 and get a second pot for half price. Order online at silverhorn.co.nz.
We're a 25 Moro Place at Dog with Tails Cafe and Bar. So we take coffee very seriously. We do what's called contract roasting, so we're creating our own roasting profile and then doing our own blends. We're really focused on the craft of what we're doing. You know, we're going back, instead of going on mass-produced sort of cheap things, we're taking the time to really craft what we're making. Make it so anyone can come here and have a feed and be able to get something they're able to eat or that they want to eat as well. You're kind of getting a taste of cafes from all around the world when you come here.
From rare to the recent, visit the legendary Hard to Find for your quality secondhand books. With the largest stock in New Zealand and a friendly book-loving atmosphere. For good prices, buying or selling, come visit 20 Dowling Street. Bring some more joy into your world by adopting one of our adult animals at SPCA Otago. Call now on 473 8252. Please adopt a pet now. They will love you forever.
Here is this week's Mole Map UV report. Did you know, in recent years, the number of New Zealanders dying from melanoma has been as high as the road toll?
If you've ever been on a sunbed or been badly sunburnt, what are the chances you could have melanoma? Remove the doubt. Get a mole map.
Travelling this weekend? Think slow.
Gillian's and Silverhorn bring you Rub of the Green, lawn bowls from around the south, Saturday night at 7, replaying on Sunday at 1 p.m. and Tuesday at 3:30.
Thanks for staying with the South today. For one man, Orientation 2017 holds a special significance because it's OUSA events manager Dan Hendra's last year on the job. Before he moves on from the role, we thought we'd take some of his time to reminisce about his favourite O Week memories.
It's hard to believe, but just a couple of nights ago, this stadium was packed with toga-clad youngsters as far as the eye could see. Yeah. This was the man behind the OUSA Toga Party and other successful O Week initiatives. Craft beer connoisseur and events manager Dan Hendra.
From creating the craft beer and food festival to
moving the orientation events down to the stadium over the last 6 years, to creating the system and guidelines for the Hyde Street party.
It's a legacy he leaves behind as he wraps up from 6 years working with OUSA.
I think this year in particular has been extremely mellow. Students at the events here, as well as just around, I believe, have been really well behaved.
Hendra has managed 34 events at the Forsyth Bar Stadium, with his 2016 Macklemore and Ryan Lewis show selling out 4 weeks in advance.
What about the fact that the wheelie bin racing is coming back? What are your thoughts on that?
Yeah, I mean, that's just a silly thing to do. Students sometimes are a little bit silly, and they just need to think things through a little bit more. I'm sure now that it's been raised that it's not probably the brightest thing to do. There hopefully isn't any ongoing issue there.
He looks forward to having more time to devote to his Dunedin Craft Beer and Food Festival and putting his feet up to watch the cricket. Roselle LeBone, The South Today.
Well done, that man. Otago Polytechnic has gone stripey for a good cause this week. The school is the first Institute of Technology and Polytechnic in New Zealand to gain the Rainbow Tick certification.
Otago Polytechnic is now a Rainbow Tick accredited learning institution. The tick means the Polytech is an equal opportunity employer for lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, intersex and queer staff. For every night this past week, Otago Polytechnic's 4th Street facing building has been lit up and the rainbow flag has been flying from the flagpole. The point is to make those marginalised more visible and to help eliminate workplace discrimination. Otago Polytechnic organisational researcher Stuart Terry says discrimination in the workplace can sometimes be subtle.
It's not really overt discrimination, but it's about for people having to come out time after time after time. And someone's asked a question for me, they ask you, what does your wife do? Or for a woman, what does your husband do? So they have to make that decision at that stage. Do they out themselves? And so for a woman, no, I have a wife. My partner is a woman.
The Polytech will work each year to retain its accreditation and to ensure the goal of equal opportunity employment is extended to all members of staff. Roselle LeBone, The South Today.
A Dunedin hairdresser aiming to reach a world record for the most consecutive number of haircuts in a 24-hour period didn't quite make the cut. Starting at noon yesterday, it was always going to be a long night for Stacey Warrington. She was attempting to break a Guinness World Record and to raise money for the Otago Community Hospice at the same time. The only rules were is that she must use scissors and clippers for the cut to count, and a minimum of 2 centimetres had to be taken off. The record of 526 haircuts in 24 hours was achieved by a London hairdresser in 2011. The Dunedin hairdresser managed to cut 145 hairstyles by this morning and is looking now forward to a very well-deserved break.
Do you know what? Last night is kind of a bit of a blur at the moment because it was so full on yesterday. I was kind of made to come off the floor about 1 o'clock in the morning just to have a decent half hour break. But the conversations, they've just been all about the record really. The public have just wanted to know, you know, my background behind wanting to support the hospice.
$600 was generously donated by the community, and once she's rested, Ms. Warrington will personally deliver it to the hospice. Still to come on The South Today, top flight PGA golfing action swings into Queenstown next month, and we sneak a look under the covers of tomorrow's ODT, and of course the weather, the temperatures, and what's going to be on the barbecue.
Dunedin is recognised by UNESCO as a city of literature. Find out how this came about and what it means for the city. In Dunedin, a city of literature, 7 p.m. Sundays. Proudly brought to you by How to Find Books.
The University of Otago, an institute of world-class education and the social epicentre of the city, with outfits needed for more formal functions like the ball and for less formal functions like
the zoo. Are you sure?
Yeah, trust me.
Yeah, Dad, you'll definitely see me. I'm the one in the yellow and blue face paint and the onesie in the zoo.
For over 35 years, Roslyn Mowers and Heating have been selling and servicing outdoor power equipment and are well established in home heating, installing wood fires. Call in and meet the friendly team. Roslyn Mowers and Heating, 150 Kaikarai Valley Road.
Hi, welcome back to Alex Campbell Menswear. We're filming again from our Mosgiel store. We're having a three-store-wide sizzling summer sale. It's the end of the season. We have sizzling prices in short-sleeve shirts, polos, shorts, jeans. We've got specials in trousers. It's a sizzling summer sale.
Every reason, every season, we're proud to dress the region. Alex Campbell Menswear, it fits.
It's a sizzling summer sale.
Is this week's Mole Map UV report. Did you know, in recent years, the number of New Zealanders dying from melanoma has been as high as the road toll?
If you've ever been on a sunbed or been badly sunburnt, what are the chances you could have melanoma? Remove the doubt. Get a Mole Map.
Garage Door Dunedin, delivering quality stylish garage doors in Dunedin for over 15 years. New doors, replacement doors, repairs and maintenance are all part of Garage Door's quality service. Garage Door Dunedin offers a full range of modern quality doors to suit any home. Come visit the team at 553 Kaikoura Valley Road. Visit www.garagedoor.co.nz or call us on 488 5676.
Get finance and get on the road. Talk to MTF today.
Thank you for staying with The South Today. American professional golfer Heath Slocum leads a quartet of world-class players confirmed for next month's New Zealand Open in Queenstown. Slocum has seven professional wins, including four on the PGA Tour's name. The 93rd New Zealand Open is a million-dollar Tier 1 event for the PGA Tour of Australasia and is run in partnership with Japan Golf Tour and the Asian Golf Tour. Heath Slocum is amongst the world's top 50 players and will be joined by Koreans Hyung-Hang Song and his fellow PGA player SJ Andrews Park. Also due to take to the fairways is European Tour winner Marcus Fraser from Australia. Goodness me. Play is scheduled to begin in Queenstown at the Millbrook Resort and at the Hills on March the 9th. Goodness. Love this story. The North Otago AMP Showgrounds will be heaving with people and animals and machinery and, of course, baking and preserves this weekend at its annual display of rural life. Parents were busy dropping off lovingly made baking this morning to the showgrounds, ready for judging ahead of a very busy schedule. The AMP show is one of the most important events on the farming calendar, and it gathers people from all points of the compass from all over North Otago.
It's a marrying of the town folk with the country folk. You get all the animals coming in, you get the horse riders coming in, you get the bakers coming in with the good old-fashioned baking and the home preserves. It really is the one day of the year where the country gets to display the harvest, I suppose.
There will be over 90 exhibitors spread over 280 trade sites, and there's even a free treasure hunt around the showgrounds. I like pumpkin pie. And it was a mixture of colour and academic pride that Pacifica Health Science students were welcomed to a new year of studies this week. Special guests spoke about their challenges and successes growing up, and a gift was presented to acknowledge management at the University of Otago's Pacific Island Centre.
Stories of travel far from home and finding a new way forward were in abundance yesterday at Otago University's Hunter Building as Pacific students begin another academic year. Tongan MP Jenny Salisa spoke directly to pupils from her experiences, appealing to them to value their education and opportunities and to always be aware of the difficulties faced by the less fortunate.
There is a triple jeopardy for child health in Aotearoa New Zealand. First, poverty. Second, unhealthy housing. And third, inadequate basic health care.
While Salisa talked about the suffering she had encountered in the lives of her lower socio-economic constituents, Reverend Dr. Tokoro discussed the importance of humility.
Striving for academic success is important, and I believe so is this thing that Jesus talks about, humility.
The event celebrated the role of faith, family, and of course, music. In the coming years, Otago University anticipates an even greater intake of Pacific medical students and a wider impact to the school and beyond. Roselle Labone, The South Today.
Nice. And now recapping tonight's top stories on The South Today. The head of Dunedin's St. Paul's Anglican Church, the Bishop of Dunedin, Calvin Wright, has today denied suggestions the church is broke and in trouble. There will no doubt be plenty of blood, sweat and tears over the next week as 300 athletes battle out in the God Zone Adventure Race in Queenstown, and a community hub in Riverton has met its fundraising target to buy the building it operated from the same estuary front location for over 15 years. All right, it's a great big packed edition in the ODT. Craig, what's going on?
Certainly is. We've got a really strong story. We talked earlier about Delta being the story that keeps giving, and, and that's the case. We've got a group of seven Saddle Hill property owners who we understand are suing Delta for more than $2 million because they believe they were to blame for the fire back in 2015.
I remember, quite a significant
fire around Saddle Hill area.
Indeed.
I think there's something like 10 buildings, including garages, damaged. They're not saying too much about the nature of their claims, but we understand it's to do with mismanagement of some safety equipment in the power lines there. Branches fell on the lines which started the fire, and there was some sort of switch that shouldn't have turned the power back on but did.
We'll see you in court.
Exactly. We're also following on the Cadbury's theme as well, and we've talked to some local businesses. If you remember, Dave Cullett said at the time that, you know, there was problems for manufacturers out of Dunedin and we perhaps needed to diversify. We've talked to some local manufacturers who are thriving. Uh-huh. The likes of Tuapeka Print, Harroways and Progressive Plastics, that's quite hard to say.
Yep.
They're all doing big exports at the moment, increasing staffing numbers as well, so they're doing really well.
Excellent, Craig. I'll wind you up here. Thank you very much. Thank you. A good addition. All right, quickly now, let's go to our weather.
This weather update proudly brought to you in association with Silverhorn Sportsville.
It's so beautiful out there. This is blue sky over Dunedin. Oh my goodness, what a good town. And God's Own competitors preparing for Queenstown. Looking across the south and everywhere that you look, Dunedin, it's beautiful tonight. Over the weekend, you can look for 16 and 7 light, fine conditions almost everywhere you look. And for Sunday, 5 and 14, you may get a few showers. If we look in all around the country too, 13 in Invercargill tonight, your weekend numbers are 9 and 14. Sunday, look out, 6 and 16, maybe some late showers for you. But that is about it. And what a magnificent week it has been. We have laughed and cried and we've agonized with you. We're also very, very proud of you. So here we go. You're good people. Have a good weekend.
This bulletin proudly brought to you in association with Alex Campbell's Menswear.
Supporting local content so you can see more of New Zealand on air.